Hi, and welcome to a new series on my channel I am calling A Beginner's Guide to Collecting Stamps. If you are new to the hobby, let me start off by saying congratulations. You have discovered a fantastic pastime. It is enriching, it is rewarding, it's also really relaxing. If you're a collector and have collected for years, I'd love it if you'd think about those days that you started collecting, back when you started collecting. What would you tell yourself then that you've since learned about this pastime? Drop a comment in the comment section below, and perhaps we can build some community here to help those of us that are starting off in our stamp collecting journey. And as always, if you have any questions for me, please feel free to ask. I'm always happy to help as I can. So, episode one, I thought I would take us back to the beginning of stamp collecting. Not way, way back, but certainly back a bit. In those days, what you would typically have is you'd typically have an album like this one right here. And you would spend countless hours of enjoyment finding stamps in any way, shape, or form you could find them, and then hinging them into the album using hinges like these. And over time, some other methods were developed for storing your stamps that moved away from hinges, because these can damage your stamps, and that's not a good thing. But between you and me, I still use hinges from time to time because it's fun. And I figure when it's used stamps, I'll put them into a book like this. So I'm going to go through the process of hinging. And I'm also going to talk a little bit about one of the most common ways people got stamps back in the day, and you still can today. And that is with a packet. So companies created packets like these of stamps and sold them to young and old stamp collectors. And generally, they held, you know, common run-of-the-mill stamps. But collectors would receive these, and they would spend hours going through each individual one and become fascinated by what this hobby is ultimately about, and that is the stamps themselves. So I went to my local hobby shop, and I found a packet. And I thought I would do just like we used to do and spend some good time with a packet. I have no idea what I will find in these. Perhaps like most packets of old, they will be filled with very, very common stamps, but so be it. I'm actually going to set aside my album for now and deal with that in a minute. All right, so you'd get your packet. This is chock full of stamps. Wow. How fun is this? And the first thing you would do is you would sort them by country, or at least I do, as you learn about each individual stamp. And so that's what I'm going to do now. And I'll let you in on a little secret. Sorting stamps is one of the most relaxing activities I know. Dad? Yes, child of mine.
Come up here.
Can I do what now?
Can
I'm starting stamps. Does it have to be at this moment? I mean, I can be there in a second. So what I was saying about sorting stamps is it takes you out of the flow of your day. And you can just totally become enthralled with what you're doing. As you learn about each individual stamp. Look at that nice little USSR stamp. And I have to think of myself as a child in the midst of the Cold War in the 60s and looking at this stamp and being just fascinated. Absolutely fascinated. Time to return to the stamp table. And what I was saying and what I'd like to ultimately say about packets is that they produced a lot of albums that are still around that are mostly full of common stamps. And the reason for that is that a lot of kids got albums for Christmas and got a packet like this and put those stamps from that packet into that album, and then that is the entire collection. It happened all the time. And what that means then is that you have an album that is full of very cool stamps. I don't want to say anything bad about the stamps themselves, because every stamp is fascinating to me. But they are common. And they are, thus, if you are in the collectibles, if you're in the collecting field today, they're what you have to weed through to find the gems. Just something to keep in mind. So that was the growth of the hobby for many years, was the packet industry and the albums that they produced. Now, hopefully I have made clear, I think those kids undoubtedly spent wonderful time creating those albums and putting them together. It's just for us collectors today, something to keep in mind. You know, when you see an album for $15 on eBay, it might have one packet's worth of stamps in it. So, now that being said, the next step in the process would be to find which stamps you want to include in your album. And so I am going to do that now. And I think I'm going to focus on this little USSR section because I like these stamps. Well, as it turned out, the album I showed you at the beginning goes to 1945, and none of the stamps in my packet date back that far, so I have found another album I had floating around, and I'm going to show you the process for hinging stamps using it. I have chosen this cool stamp from the USSR. And I'm going to put it next to its similar one right there. Now, the process is quite straightforward. The trick is to not put too much moisture onto the hinge. So you hold it in your tongs like that. You moisten the top edge first, the top flap. You shouldn't hold your stamps with your hand because it can damage the stamps. So, and then you put the hinge down like so. Don't have it too close to the top of the stamp. Hold it in place for a few seconds to let the adhesive do its trick. And then let go. And there you go. Now you're going to moisten the back end right there, the back of it. Just a tiny little bit, and then you find the home in the album, you hold it in place for a few seconds, and you can let go pretty quickly, and there you go. you have a hinged stamp for your album. It will flatten once you close the book. And that's all there is to it. That is how you hinge a stamp for your stamp album. Now, like I said at the beginning, I do use hinges from time to time because I find it enjoyable and fun. However, there are better ways of storing your stamps, and we'll get into that in the next video. But for this one, the main point I wanted to convey in episode one of A Beginner's Guide for Stamp Collecting is the enjoyment of sorting stamps. So find a bucket of stamps somewhere and sort them. The beginnings of the hobby in terms of the packets and how that contributed to an awful lot of, common albums that you can find today that aren't going to have much to add to your collection because they, in essence, were one packet and with maybe a few additions. But then most importantly, simply welcome to the hobby. It is phenomenal. It has really been an enjoyable part of my life. So with that, please do like and subscribe the video, or please do like the video and subscribe to the channel. It means a great deal to me. And until next time, take care.